Emails show Planned Parenthood is behind a California rule to make churches pay for abortions. In 2014, state law forces religious groups, including churches, to cover elective abortions for employees. Yesterday, three churches filed a notice of appeal against the measure. Joining me now to discuss this story is Edward Condon, Washington, D.C. Bureau for Catholic News Agency. Ed, what do these emails from Planned Parenthood actually say?
Well, it's an entire email chain that's been submitted to the Ninth Circuit as part of the evidence in this notice of appeal. And what they show is systematic communication between Planned Parenthood officials and California state officials at the Department of Health and Human Services. And what they show is systematic checking in by Planned Parenthood on state officials to make sure they're complying with their demands and basically threatening them with a legislative campaign if they don't comply.
Pretty disturbing, for especially for a lot of pro-lifers to hear about this. Do they specifically mention Catholic churches or Catholic universities?
Absolutely. At this point in 2014, what had happened was two Catholic universities, Loyola Marymount and Santa Clara Universities, had their health care plans for their employees approved by the state authorities, and these didn't cover elective abortions. But this wasn't good enough for Planned Parenthood, and they came back and said, unless you close this loophole, unless you have this fix, as they called it, we are going to trigger a whole legislative campaign to close this loophole ourselves. So either they said to the Department of Health and Human Services, you fix this or we're going to.
What do you think this says about Planned Parenthood and lobbyists for Planned Parenthood that they would go this far? We suspected this, but...
I think what's really disturbing about these emails is it shows the level of interference they can play, not just in the legislative process, not just in public campaigns, but behind the scenes, meeting with state officials and effectively operating as a check over their shoulder to make sure they're all reading from the same script. It shows the level of complicity in some areas. And I mean, it's very worrying that state officials are willing to bow to this kind of pressure.
So where do we go from here? What's next?
Well, the notice of appeal has been given to the U.S. Ninth Circuit. We'll see the case come up there. Hopefully we can get more will come to light. We'll understand more about this, and hopefully we can claw back a measure of religious freedom in California.
Okay, well, we'll continue to be watching this because this is still developing here. And, of course, we'll ask our followers, of course, to continue to follow Catholic news agencies. You guys give updates as well. Edward Condon, Washington, with the Washington, D.C. Bureau Chief for Catholic News Agency, thanks so much for the update.
My pleasure.